The Life and Sad Ending of Maria Callas. Maria Callas was born Sophia Cecelia Kalos on December 2, 1923, to Greek parents George and Evangelia at Flower Hospital in Manhattan. Her father owned and ran a pharmacy in Manhattan, where she spent much of her childhood. She had a sister, Yakinthi. Her brother, Vasilis, died before she was born. Her parents were an incompatible couple, as her mother was a domineering while her father was a laid-back person. In 1937, Evangelia returned to Athens, taking her daughters with her. When Maria's talent for singing became apparent, she began an unduly pressivizer of her. She was also made to feel ugly, fat, and clumsy. Initially tortured by Maria Trivella at the National Conservatory, she impressed the Spanish soprano, Elvia de Hidalgo, in an audition and was instructed by him at the Athens Conservatory from 1939. Maria Callas' professional debut happened in 1941 as Beatrice in Franz von Supp's Boccaccio. The next year, she starred as Tosca and sang for Martha in Tyfield by Eugene D'Albert in the Olympia Theater. In 1945, she went back to America when her father planned to restart her career. Her musical career had already been established with 56 performances and 20 recitals on her credit. Giovanni Zantello, an artistic director from the 1947 Verona Opera Festival, was in America scouting fresh talent. Engaged by Zantello in La Gioconda and conducted by Tullio Serafina, she debuted in Italy. Though her performance was a success, she found work hard to come by. But after she sang Isolde, an Italian under Seferin, she began to engage in work mostly in Turin, Italy. In 1948, she sang Norma in Florence. This was the first time she performed in the opera. Over her career, she would perform 89 more times. She sang at the Teatro Colón de Buenos Aires, Argentina, in 1949. Her husband, Meneghini, again became her manager. He was responsible for developing her career for the next couple of years. A performance at Milan's La Scala had eluded in 1950 when she played the lead role as Verdi's side, Ada, and was greeted as a lukewarm reception, much to her disappointment. In 1951, she won over La Scala with I Vespri Siciliani and received critical acclaim. She went on to perform 26 operas at the world's main opera house. In 1952, she debuted in London at the Royal Opera House as Ada Galicia in Norma, the veteran mezzo-soprano Ebe Stignani. Her love affair with the house continued for a good 13 years. Following a contract with EMI, her first commercial recording as Lucia de Lammermoor, complete opera recordings at La Scala of I Puritani and Cavalierata Rusticana and Tosca were done in 1953. In 1955, she was sued by her former manager, Eddie Bagorazzi, who claimed that her sole representative and wanted compensation for his expenses incurred by him. The case was settled out of court. She made her first appearance at the Metropolitan in New York in 1956. She performed Norma, Tosca, and Lucia. Despite being labeled an ungrateful daughter by the press, she received a standing ovation. Her relationship with La Scala went sour after she refused to accommodate the unscheduled performance at the Edinburgh Festival conducted by them. In 1958, the Metropolitan Opera, New York, terminated the contract with her. In 1958, scheduled to perform at the Rome Opera House before Italy's president, she fell sick due to the previous night's celebrations and drinking. The performance was canceled and she received much bad press. Her late-stage performance was in the Royal Opera House known as Covent Garden in 1965. She acted in the film Medea by the Italian filmmaker Pier Paolo Pasliani, which was not successful. In the 70s, she staged a series of joint recitals and conducted masterclasses at the Juilliard School in New York. Her final public performance was in 1974 in Sapporo, Japan. Interesting. In 1944, she performed a role of Leonore in Greek version of Fidelio, the German opera by Beethoven of the Odeon and Herodotus Atticus. German critic Friedrich Herzog considered it to be the greatest triumph. In 1949, chosen as Elvira in I Puritani, a La Fenice at short notice, her incredible bel canto performance rekindled interest in her neglected operas of Cherubini, Bellini, Donizetti, and Rossini. Voted in the greatest soprano by BBC Music Magazine in 2007, Maria Callas was posthumously honored with the Grammy Lifetime Achievement Award. She was voted into the Gramophone Magazine of Hall of Fame 5 years later. Between 1949 and 1959, she was married to a wealthy industrialist, Giovanni Battista Menihani, who began to manage her career. She had a 9-year love affair with Aristotle Onassis, and they were expected to marry, but he married Jackie Kennedy instead, John F.K.'s widow. The affair continued clandestinely until Onassis died in 1975, leaving her heartbroken. In 1953, determined to look more attractive and to do justice to the dramatic role she was performing, she lost almost 80 pounds. Some say it had affected her strength of her voice. There were many rumors as to how this soprano shed that extra flab. One such interesting rumor was that she had swallowed a tapeworm. This soprano was short-sighted and refused to wear her glasses or contact lenses. It was frustrating for conductors who hoped the singer would watch for tempos.